everybody. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Dr. Carmen Bryant, and this is Overcoming Narcissist Abuse. Thank you guys so much for joining me. To all the new subscribers, I am truly and thoroughly honored that you be here. And before I start, please allow me to say to Life Coach Christina Michelle, thank you so much for your donation. I am truly honored. Thank you so much for the accolades as well. I am truly honored. You know, whenever you want me to support you, I will do the same likewise, and I'll look you up as well. So before we get started, let me put out a disclaimer. Today's topic is going to be a little intense. When I say intense, mate, grown folk conversation. And so if you guys are sharing with young people, you guys are going to have to look through this video to make sure it is appropriate for them to listen to. Not saying that I'm inappropriate at the information I'm giving you. You guys just have to make sure that it's age appropriate if you're showing it to younger people, because today I wanted to talk about the porn addiction. So do understand that, you know, porn addiction does not necessarily constitute a person having narcissistic personality disorder or even a cluster B personality disorder. Porn addiction is just that, porn addiction. Just like alcohol or drug addictions, gambling, smoking, shopaholics, you know, it is a addiction. And porn addiction, the same chemicals in the brain that is affected by drug and alcohols are the same chemicals that are affected with porn addiction. The oxytocin, the dopamine, the serotonin, you know. And what it is most people become addicted to something, just like you became addicted to the narcissist, because those chemicals were affected. And it is for any kind of addiction, and especially for porn addiction, it is a coping mechanism. So when the levels of stress or anxiety increases, that is a release for, you know, whether it's drugs, alcohol, cigarette, you know, some people smoke when they're stressed, and porn. And so with porn, you also know that there's also involved in it masturbation. And so now, if you take the addiction and put it on a narcissist, and remember, I said that people that have narcissistic personality disorder can also have all sorts of other mental health disorders, depression, a lot of them have post-traumatic stress disorder, anxiety, you know, excuse me, you guys, schizophrenia, borderline personalities, or the malignant ones, the antisocial personality disorder, they can have all sorts of other issues or other mental health disorders. And addiction is also a part of that. Some of them are drug addicts, as you know, alcohol, you know, addicted to alcohol, drugs, gambling, whatever, and porn. And so what makes a porn addiction really bad for a narcissist is that a narcissist, number one, has no boundaries. They're above the law. The law doesn't apply to them, black and white thinkers. And so you do know that anytime you begin to use drugs, and whether it's recreational or not, there is a chance of addiction. And not only addiction, but the more hardcore stuff. You start off with weed, you start off with cocaine, you start off with crack, and you know, you keep on going till you have a plethora of drugs in your system where you have to maintain your high. Your tolerance level gets high. No different than porn addiction. Tolerance level gets high. And it takes more and more and more hardcore pornography in order to satisfy that insatiable need, that sexual gratification, meaning that they may go from soft porn to hard porn. And some of them, and I've met them that went from hardcore soft porn, hardcore porn, switched over to and watching bestiality and then child porn. And then, as you know, they're cracking down, thank God, cracking down on sex trafficking, child pornography, and people being arrested for it. So a lot of times you'll also find them in trouble with the law. You'll find them problems at work. They're so addicted, they find problems at work because they're illegally watching pornography on government systems at workplace. You know, it becomes normal to them, where it's no big deal. Masturbation, you know, masturbating wherever when stress is high, getting to a point where another person cannot gratify them. So you'll find, like for example, in men, you'll find them with problems with erectile dysfunction. You'll find in women, a lot of times they have problems with orgasm, and for men as well, you know, they have problems with orgasm or sexual gratification because they've masturbated or watched pornography where it's at a height where a person cannot satisfy them. They're not gratified. And so, you know, you do have those that are cerebral narcissists. Those that are cerebral narcissists are thinkers. They get thought fuel a lot, and they're manipulative. They use sex when they want to hook someone because they use it as a weapon, but sex is not their top priority. They really, it's irrelevant to them. They don't care. A somatic narcissist, however, is one that is about looks, sex, but a lot of them are also addicted to porn. And that's why I tell you guys, you know, never underestimate a narcissist. Some of you guys are turning the blind eye. You know, this person has a problem with pornography. Pornography leads into other things, and you have to safeguard your children. So if you have children in the home, don't ever underestimate and blow off a narcissist by saying he or she would never do that. That's a parent, that's a grandparent. They would never do it. And see, hindsight is 20/20, where many people grow up later on and find out their children were molested by the narcissist. And a lot of them did have pornography addictions. And so if your spouse, lover, friend, boyfriend, girlfriend, boo, whatever, has a porn addiction, it is best for you to safeguard your children. Don't ever think that you're being neurotic or paranoid. You're safeguarding your children. They don't want help because there's nothing wrong with them. There's something wrong with you. And then you'll hear the excuse, well, if you only did this or if you did this. they also have unrealistic expectations when it comes to sex. You know, you'll find them asking you to do things that are just strange or awkward. You know, it's two things, the porn addiction or, you know, the other sources of supply that they get involved with. They bring stuff from the outside into the marriage or into the relationship that you know is not something that you've ever done before, or that's not a habit that they have in the first place. And so, but with porn addictions, you know, you're looking at material, pornographic material that's not real. It's done in a studio, number one. And number two, 9 times out of 10, the people are, you know, they're adult entertainers. A lot of them can or are drug addicts, prostitutes. And then the films that they're watching, whether it's an hour long or not, that is unrealistic. What they're looking at is a fantasy, is unrealistic, is clips put together to create, but they don't see that. You know that, but they don't see that. So their expectation of you is to perform the way that they see it on television. So it's unrealistic expectation that you know is just not real. They ask you to do things that are almost unnatural and you feel uncomfortable. Anytime a person is asking you to do things sexually that is uncomfortable for you and you don't want to do it and you feel pressured to do it, or you feel harassed to do it or nagged to do it, and you just, and if it, you don't do it, you do not do it, you take back your boundaries, you take back, but you do risk the chance that they go find someone else. And for some of you, you're so desperate to keep them that you're willing to do anything they ask you to do. But anything that you do is never good enough for a narcissist. And so I'm telling you, porn addiction does not necessarily negate or negate does not necessarily constitute a person having a personality disorder. Porn addiction doesn't mean that the person has narcissistic personality disorder or personality disorder. Some people have a porn addiction, you know, spending hundreds and thousands of dollars on pornographic material and toys and all that kind of stuff, causing financial problems for the family, intimacy problems, you know, sexual problems, you know, erectile dysfunction, orgasmic problems, you know, any kind of, you know, relationship problem, work problems, you know, getting in trouble at work, you know. And just, there are some people that just watch porn whenever on their phone. It doesn't even matter. They have no boundary. It becomes such a normal thing to them. You know, all of a sudden what right is wrong and what's wrong is right, you know. And so, but that does not mean that that person has narcissistic personality disorder. So you can't look at people that have an addiction and think that they also have this disorder. But if it is a narcissist that has a porn addiction along with everything else that they have no boundaries, they're above the law. You know, whatever what applies to other people does not apply to them. You know, they can watch and do whatever they want to in the privacy of their home. This is our relationship. You know, you should be willing to try. Why can't you do this? You just don't gratify them. It's not your fault. It's their fault. It's not their fault. Take the blame off of yourself and look at the person that you're dealing with. For some of you, it's very hard, and some of you are willing to do anything to keep these people in your life. It might be better for you to let them go. And on top of that, I say it again in the military, say again, I say over and over again, listen to me, safeguard your children. Do not put anything past a narcissist, especially those that have a porn addiction. Remember, they don't look at their children the way that you look at the children. Too many of you are trying to, you know, you're frustrated and you're hurt because you're trying to figure out the narcissist based off of how you think. They don't think like you. They don't have empathy and compassion like you. They don't have the ability to connect to people like you do. And so you're trying, you're frustrated because you're trying to figure out, I don't understand why they don't understand. But those are your children. They look at the children as an extension of themselves. It is their, they are their property. And they can do whatever they want to do with their property because I own you and I own the children. And so you don't put anything past the narcissist. I'm not saying just go out and accuse someone, you know, of violating your children because you're going to have to prove it. But what I'm saying is be aware, watch, protect, safeguard the best way that you can. If you start seeing things, you know, start looking up on Google signs and symptoms of, you know, child sexual abuse, you know, get them into help, get them around someone. Some of you guys are afraid to have CPS calls. Some of you guys are afraid for people to make a report. Is it going to safeguard your kids? Because in the long run, your kids are going to look at you like you were the one that should have protected me. You were my protector and you did nothing because you were so wrapped up in this individual that you just put us out there and we became we became a sacrifice all because of your needs and you. Put your emotions aside. If you have children, put your emotions aside. Put yourself aside. Now it's about your children. Don't worry about you, it's about your children. But I need to be satisfied, I wanna be happy, but you got kids. So now the responsibilities have shifted. Look out for those kids and look out for yourself. So hopefully this has helped you. I know it's a short, brief one. Try to make them a little more shorter, a little briefer, so that I have more time to do what I have to do during the day. But I thank you guys so much for tuning in. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. It is Dr. Carmen Bryant, Overcoming Narcissist Abuse. If you look down below in the links, you will see where my book is. It is Unmasking the Illusion of Perfection. And it's Barnes & Noble. There's several bookstores that sell it, but it's Barnes & Noble and Amazon. And you can buy Kindle, ebook, you can buy hard copy, soft copy. Share it with your teens. Share it with your teens because some of your teens have already entered into abusive relationships where these personalities are developing. They're not fully developed, but they're developing. And some of these teens need to have awareness. When you give them knowledge and understanding early on, they can make informed decisions. They can ask more questions. You know, and you're dealing with teenagers that are trying to discover themselves in the first place. Your greatest advocates are right there, those teens. You know, what they say is very relevant. They're not dumb. Listen to them. Talk to them. Listen to them, parents. Listen to what they're saying. Sometimes they're telling you without telling you. You got to stop talking. You stop talking so much and listen to them. What they say is not, I mean, everything that they say, excuse me, guys, everything that they say, you know, they're still learning. They're still growing. And so everything that they say, you know, you got to have compassion for the kids. Listen to them. Be a parent that listens to what they have to say because some of them are already going through it. So you need to catch them early on so they'll have more information as opposed to where we were and where we weren't. And look where we ended up at, right? And so also I have two Facebook pages. One is my professional Facebook page, Psychological Health Consultants and Services, and my book, which is Overcoming Narcissist Abuse. You're welcome to hit the thumbs up, the like button on both of them. I usually put my videos on all of them. One is reserved for professionalism, so I put my little professional stuff on there when I get a chance, and the other one is the book. I put other stuff on there and pictures. You're welcome to join me on Twitter. Sometimes I tweet, sometimes I retweet. My mentor, make sure you go and check out my mentor's YouTube channel, Helen Sadler, Destiny Helper. For those of you that have spiritual and biblical questions concerning narcissist abuse, she is excellent at giving you answers. She's the presiding prelay of Interest Chambers Global Ministry, my mentor, my spiritual parent, my pastor. I love her. She's awesome. Go support her, you guys. And she will answer a lot of questions that I don't answer because I'm on the clinical side of the house. So I usually send you guys over there so that she can answer that question. I try not to cross over to, you know, try to cross over and leave that for her. But thank you guys so much for supporting me. Thank you once again, Life Coach Christina Michelle. I appreciate you. I really do. And that's from the heart. Thank you guys so much. Also, look under the link as well. It's betterhelp.com. It's a sponsored link. betterhelp.com/Dr. Carmen. And you guys go and check out that for those of you that are looking for licensed counselors within your region. It is a global program. You can find licensed counselors within your area. You can go in and you can put in information. Don't go in and look and say if you specialize in narcissist abuse recovery. Some of them may have it, some of them may not. Trauma professionals, domestic violence professionals, those that understand psychological abuse and the after effects of psychological abuse, that's what you're looking for, because narcissist abuse seems to be a buzzword. So many people, like, you know, unless you really know what you're talking about, it's a buzzword. So people usually just, yeah, whatever, you know, lawyers, judges, you know, okay, whatever, you're just throwing it out there, you don't know what you're talking about. So that's what you go look for. And those of you that are wanting to donate, I appreciate you asking me. Please, you know, go to the link below on the YouTube channel. It's PayPal, and I also have a Cash App. You're welcome to donate. Do know that it's going toward to expand this channel and to grow the channel and to grow the material and to create the classes. So I told you guys the last thing that I'm doing now, you know, with the responsibilities of my clinic is purchasing the computer. So I got the equipment, my computer crashed. I got to go back and get my laptop up and running again, get my stuff off of there. So once again, thank you guys so much. I appreciate you guys. You guys have an awesome Friday. Today is Friday, the August 16th. So I don't know when you guys are going to get this video. Some of you guys will get it next year. But August 16th, 2019, Friday. Have a happy Friday. Have a wonderful weekend. I will talk to you guys on Sunday live for question and answers between 8 and 9 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. I'll be here with you guys. I'm excited to come talk to you guys. You guys have an awesome weekend. And you guys go be great.